musicians spiritually kind of find each other. And you know when it feels good, and you know when it sort of feels good, you know when it feels fantastic, and you know when it, you know. And when it's a process. It's almost mystical.
Here we go. Yo, check it out. We just finished playing 70 plus shows all over the planet. We haven't had a new record since 1975. You don't hear us on the radio. We don't have a singer. But our fans come out to hear our band. We play our own instruments. We improvise. So man, you never know what you're gonna hear. We really thank the fans for hanging with us all these years and supporting our shows, real music shows. We survived the boy band era where no one in the band played an instrument, but everybody sang perfectly in tune. I guess because RTF is a man band. Of all the jazz rock bands of the 70s, we're the last bandstand.
My rock and roll ears, come on just a little bit closer, Don. I don't mean,
Chick and I have rock and roll ears.
Yeah.
So, how do you get rock and roll
I have to
ears?
Keep saying, huh?
How do you get rock and roll ears when you don't play rock and roll?
Oh, well, that's questionable. Medieval Overture. Well, you know, by 1975 we recorded that, I think. By then we had developed a whole bunch of stuff. We had done a lot of stuff. We made a lot of records, toured, and so the band at that point was like this perfect orchestra as a composer to think about. I knew what everyone, the sounds they made, you know, and so we already had a concept for this record. And we already had decided that we would all contribute compositions and so forth. And so I had a very specific intent about Medieval Overture, which was the overture. I wrote it as an overture. And actually, to this day, we're using it as an opening piece because it works as an overture. It's like an intro piece. It's like, ta-da, fanfare kind of thing. That was about, you know, the only thought I had on it. And then I wrote it, and there it is.
We actually wrote another overture that we've never...
Really?
Oh,
which one? We did in 83.
Oh, yeah.
That's a great piece.
That's right, yeah. Well, you know, I recorded that with the electric band. I mean, I'm sorry. Yeah, but.
What?
Really?
Blasphemy!
Oh! Yeah.
But then, those guys?
It pains me. Oh. Sammy, take it out.
We should play that. We should play all of that. Music.
Actually, there's a recording of it, of a live gig.
83. Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Worth revisiting.
Thank you.
about the word jazz, by the way? Does that bother you?
No, it doesn't bother me.
I'm very comfortable with that word, though.
It's another word.
I think when I was younger, I used to want to get more specific with the so-called genre of music that I was in. But now it's, being associated with that word, it has a specific meaning to me, but I have no problem with it.
Captain Samuel.
Yeah, really. Well, you know, that was way the other side. That was like from the first group of pieces written for the Electric group with Lenny. Lenny came to join us. We were, and you know, I remember that first rehearsal. I'm sorry, you weren't there. Steve Gadd was there on that rehearsal. I remember the first time we took out Hymn of the Seventh Galaxy. And then,
Chick, is that you?
Yeah, right. You can cut that part out. I thought you were there, but then when I looked at you, I thought, that doesn't look like Steve Gadd.
No.
Anyway, Send Your Mouse, huh? Actually, Send Your Mouse was playful. It was like Hymn of the Seventh Galaxy. We're in a spaceship. I wrote this melody. Actually, I wrote the melody. I can tell you I wrote the melody in Switzerland. I was in Switzerland with Neville. Me and Neville, a good old friend of mine, and we were spending some time in, we had rented this farmhouse, and I was practicing and writing music on my Fender Rhodes until the townspeople thought it wasn't a good idea to have us there anymore. But that's where I wrote Send Your Mouse. And when I wrote the melody, doo-doo-doo-da, boo-dee-doo-da, it just reminded me of a mouse at the helm of a spaceship. So that, you know, there's no more to it than that. No, come on, man. Hey, wait a minute, man. We don't all need to do that to have an imagination. Did you get him? You didn't get him. I'll start out by writing a piece of music and sketch it out like this with pencil and paper, so it's real quick. But then after I make a recording of it, which I've done here in Logic, I'll go to Sibelius to actually write the score out and arrange it for the band. And so when it gets printed out, it's very readable and legible and so forth, and this becomes just a note paper. This one's called Planet Chia.